Kelly's got a
good one. Oh, okay. He's born in Torrington, Connecticut, in this house, actually, to a very religious family with a father who was very much opposed to slavery. And so his awareness of abolitionist values started from a young age. And when he was 5, they moved to Ohio, and after that, they pretty much stayed in the North. And he became very involved with abolitionist movement. So Frederick Douglass once said that, though a white gentleman, Brown is in sympathy of black men and as deeply interested in our cause as though his own soul had been pierced with the iron of slavery. So coming from Frederick Douglass, that just shows how dedicated he was. And his dedication was really exemplified in the ways in which he opposed abolition peacefully. And some of the ways in which he did this included his helping to finance Walker's Appeal, his giving land to fugitive slaves, and the fact that he and his wife agreed to raise a black youth as one of their own, and his support in the establishment of the Underground Railroad, as well as his help in establishing the League of Paleodeeps, an organization that worked to protect escaped slaves from slave captures. And part of what makes John Brown interesting is that, like, in the beginning, he was a peaceful abolitionist, but then when he started to see that his peaceful tactics weren't really making a difference, and he realized how deeply entrenched slavery was into society, he kind of switched over to violent tactics. So he can't really be defined as a peaceful or violent abolitionist, because he did both during his lifetime. So once he switched over to the more violent tactics, he began leading guerrilla attacks on pro-slavery towns. His most famous attack was the raid of the federal arsenal at Harper's Ferry, which is in Virginia. So it was an attempt to start an armed slave revolt by seizing the U.S. arsenal at Harper's Ferry, but a detachment of the Marine Corps led under Robert E. Lee stopped him, so it was not successful. And he was later tried for treason and hung for what he did. And this is a flyer from people who supported him, and they were saying, pray for John Brown, because what he was doing was good. He was doing it for righteous sake and justly with his fellow men and his country, his God. So, to summarize, basically, his contribution to the abolitionist movement was that he really popularized the idea of using violence as a way to end slavery, which is a really popular idea in the Civil War. And he also gave the abolitionist cause a martyr, so he fueled more abolitionist motivation because of that. Once they saw that someone died for abolitionism, a lot of people had a renewed sense of motivation to fight for the cause.
Yeah, and he invaded the South.